In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
I welcome you to this extended Vigil Mass of Pentecost, and we're offering it for the good estate of Gladys Paul. And at the end of this Mass, we'll join the whole Church in England and Wales in praying for Her Majesty the Queen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are the Good Shepherd, leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy. The Spirit of Truth. Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
You open for your people the way from death into life. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the splendour of your glory may shine forth upon us, and that by the bright rays of the Holy Spirit, the light of your light may confirm the hearts of those born again by your grace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
So please be seated. My dear brothers and sisters, we have now begun our Pentecost vigil after the example of the apostles and disciples, who, with Mary, the mother of Jesus, persevered in prayer, awaiting the Spirit promised by the Lord. Like them, let us too listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how many great deeds God in times past did for his people. And let us pray that the Holy Spirit, whom the Father sent as the first fruits for those who believe, may bring to perfection his work in the world.
So they are all a single people with a single language, said
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your Church may always remain that holy people, formed as one by the unity of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, which manifests to the world the sacrament of your holiness and unity, and lead it to the perfection of your charity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, who in fire and lightning gave the ancient law to Moses on Mount Sinai, and on this day manifested a new covenant in the fire of the Spirit, grant, we pray, that we may always be aflame with that same Spirit whom you wondrously poured out on your apostles, and that the new Israel, gathered from every people, may receive with rejoicing the eternal commandment of your love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The hand of the Lord was made on me, and he carried me away by the Spirit.
Let us pray. O God, who have brought us to rebirth by the word of life, pour out upon us your Holy Spirit, that walking in oneness of faith, we may attain in our flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Fulfill for us your gracious promise, O Lord, we pray, so that by his coming the Holy Spirit may make us witnesses before the world to the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns for ever and ever.
We glorify you, we give thanks for your good word.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, we will through the Paschal mystery to be encompassed as a sign in 50 days. Grant that from out of the scattered nations, the confusion of many tongues may be gathered by heavenly grace into one great confession of your name. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
On the last day and greatest day of the festival, Jesus stood there and cried out, "If any man is thirsty, let him come to me. Let the man come and drink who believes in me. As scripture says, from his breast shall flow fountains of living water." He was speaking of the Spirit which those who believed in him were to receive. For there was no spirit as yet, because Jesus had not yet been glorified.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
50 days ago, we began this Easter season with the Easter Vigil in the Holy Mass. Now, as a mirror this evening, the Church, in her great love, provides a proper vigil for the solemnity of Pentecost, with the extended readings and psalms that we have listened to and have sung. That means we can celebrate the descent of the Holy Spirit afresh and with the fullness of joy. This feast counteracts humanity's evil regard for one another. The people in the book of Genesis were filled with pride, wanting to make a name for themselves, wanting to guarantee their own security by reaching heaven by their own merits. At Babel, the people have shown great arrogance in building a tower in an attempt to reach heaven. In punishment, God destroys the tower, confuses the people's language, and fragments the people's unity by banishing them to the four corners of the world. And so Pentecost is a reversal of this. The apostles, given the gifts of language to gather the nations back into the peace of God's kingdom. Babel is the opposite of Jerusalem, the city towards which all nations will flock to. But as always, we must not think too literally, for it is first to the church as the new Jerusalem that people must flock, as this too is the only gateway into the heavenly city. The sin of pride continues to trouble humanity. Instead, we must recognize that salvation is brought about by God's grace, a humility that allows us to fill our hearts with love of Him, an understanding that His commandments and His call to follow His Son will bring about our perfection, that is, the fullness of life in God's presence. This is the promise of the covenant. He will be our God, and we shall be His people. In holy baptism, we received our election as a member of His body and of His church. It's a new status which sets us apart from the world, focusing our hearts and minds on our place as a citizen of heaven. Our true home. Pentecost reminds us of our liberation from bondage, of sin and death, and that we are, of course, objects of God's love. Faithfully keeping the covenant nourishes our hope that at death our life is changed and not ended. The Christian dead are awaiting their own resurrection of the body, when their dry bones or their ashes will be revitalized. Not simply a reconstruction of that was old, but something that is new, like Christ in His risen and glorified body. It's a new beginning. We take our place in those new heavens and new earth. It's the gift of immortality. It is the culmination of our redemption that has been promised by Christ. And this, perhaps, is the difference between redemption and salvation. Now there will be a time when there is no more sin, no more death, because God will live with His people. We've been given a foretaste of this reality even now in our holy baptism. We've become a temple of the Holy Spirit, a definite sign that the day of the Lord is approaching. St. Peter will refer to this on the day of Pentecost, speaking of the outpouring of the Holy Spirit upon him and the apostles, and that through baptism and confirmation, the Spirit of God would inhabit the hearts of humanity who become new creations in Christ, through whom God will renew the face of the earth. So throughout the last 9 days, the diocese, including members of our own parish, have been praying the novena to the Holy Spirit. And as you came in, you were given an act of consecration to bring that novena to its fulfillment. So we pray together the act of consecration. I offer myself, soul and body, to you, eternal Spirit of God. I adore the brightness of your purity, the unerring keenness of your justice, and the might of your love. You are the strength and light of my soul. Mercifully guard my every thought and word, and grant that I may always watch for your light, and listen to your voice, and follow your gracious inspirations. I cling to you, and give myself to you, and ask you by your compassion to watch over me in my weakness. Held by Jesus, trusting in his sacrifice, the outpouring of himself for my sake, I implore you, adorable Spirit, helper of my infirmity, to keep me in your grace, that I may never sin against you. Give me grace, O Holy Spirit, Spirit of the Father and the Son, to say to you always and everywhere, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. Amen. As we've been doing throughout this season of Easter, we proclaim our faith using the baptismal symbol of the Roman Church, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, through the mission of the Church, the Spirit of the Lord has filled the whole world, and so we pray.
and with us as we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
In a moment of silence, we pray for our own needs and intentions.
Almighty Father, you send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. And so we ask you to hear and answer our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Pour out upon these gifts the blessing of your Spirit, we pray, O Lord, so that through them your church may be imbued with such love, that the truth of your saving mystery may shine forth for the whole world, through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children, by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
Which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servants Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of Pentecost, on which the Holy Spirit appeared to the apostles in tongues of fire, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. And be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord. We, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice and spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, the grace of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, for whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
For all him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
O God, who bestow the heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gifts of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, save Elizabeth, our Queen, and hear us on the day we call upon you. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come before you. The Lord be with you. Almighty God, we pray that your servant Elizabeth, our Queen, who by your providence has received the governance of this realm, may continue to grow in every virtue, that imbued with your heavenly grace, she may be preserved from all that is harmful and evil, and being blessed with your favour, may with the royal family come at last into your presence, through Christ who is the way, the truth, and the life, and who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen. 833. Perseverance in that same faith, and by believing may you journey from hope to clear vision. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
We are the ones who
Finish your